everyone, thank you for watching. Today's video is going to be my lip picks for the month of December. So if you are new to my lip picks series, I do have a playlist. I will link it down below. And I am now doing a top five, bottom five format for my lip picks. So basically what I do is I look back at the month prior at all of the different lipsticks, lip combos that I wore throughout my YouTube videos. And I generally post 6 or 7 days a week. So I have a lot of choices in there. And then I choose my top five lipsticks, formulas, colors, all of that. And then I also choose out my bottom five and I go through those with you. I do swatches and I also insert the photo of me wearing the lipstick so you can see what it looks like on me. So if you're interested in seeing my lip picks for the month of December, why don't we go ahead and get started? Okay, so I will say that after I made my list and I was looking through it, there wasn't a ton that I could find for my bottom category. I was able to get five, but there wasn't really a ton that spoke to me that was like, that was one that I know right off the bat that I really, really, really don't like. So again, like I try to say when I'm doing the top five, bottom five for the lip picks, sometimes it's as simple as I didn't love the color. Sometimes I don't like the formula. Sometimes it's just not a, preference, an actual lip product preference for me, that sort of thing. So sometimes it's not like too deep and I'm not trying to say some of these in the bottom five are like the worst things ever type thing, but ooh, it was kind of tough getting my bottom five for this month. But the first ones that I wanted to mention are these lip glosses from Too Faced. Now, right off the bat, I'm not a big lip gloss girl. I say this every single time I'm wearing lip gloss in a video. I don't know why that is, but I tend to prefer liquid lipsticks or like matte lipsticks. That's just kind of my thing. Glossy lips are not always it, but also, another reason why I didn't love these is because they are super, super glittery, like actual glittery on the lips. Then they're really hard to remove. I do think that they look pretty, don't get me wrong, but I don't know, just between it being like a glittery lip gloss formula, having the issues removing them, I just can't say that they were an absolute favorite of mine. So again, if I'm doing top five, bottom five, I would put these in the bottom five category. Now, I will say that the shade that was in collaboration with Jordan Woods, this one here in Social Butterfly, this is probably my favorite out of the three that I did try. I'll go ahead and swatch these though. They are glosses, though they're a little bit hard to show up. This first one here is going to be in Sunset Crush. And I can leave my video linked down below where I was actually testing out the Too Faced Pretty Rich collection. And then I did swatch all of these on my lips. So I don't have like one singular photo to show. But that one there is a Sunset Crush. But yeah, the Social Butterfly would be probably my most favorite out of everything that I tried, but I just don't see myself reaching for these very often or, you know, wearing them super often. Again, just the actual like glittery formula is just not something I'm a fan of. You know, if that is something that you're a fan of, I mean, they're not like terrible, but again, personal preference wise and all that. This one is called Pretty Penny. And then the last one is the Social Butterfly. The packaging on these are really beautiful and all that fun stuff, but just not a super fan for myself. So this last swatch here is in Social Butterfly. So those are a few lip glosses from Too Faced. Just can't say that these are going to be a favorite of mine. So next up, I have a lip product from Charlotte Tilbury. This is one of the Hollywood lips. So this is more of a liquid lipstick. This is in the shade Showgirl. So I have tried this formula in the past. I believe I put it in Makeup Monthly and I put it in the okay category. Again, I don't think this is like the worst liquid lipstick that I've ever tried, but I also, it's definitely not a favorite of mine. If I'm comparing everything, especially because I had so many good lip products, I think in December, this one would definitely go into the bottom category. I have another shade in this one called Too Bad I'm Bad, and I do prefer this shade here in Showgirl. So I did wipe off those swatches and my hand is now full of glitter. So again, just a lot of glitter over there. So first things is that I don't love the applicator on this, and I kind of wondered if it was just like I had a funky applicator with the Too Bad I'm Bad, but this applicator is the same. It's just kind of like, I described it as it looked like someone tried to take a bite out of the applicator. I don't know. It's just kind of odd. This is also a pretty dry formula, and I feel like it can get pretty crumbly on me quickly and just feel more drier on my lips. So that makes me not love it as much. Again, I think the shade is really pretty, and the makeup look where I had it on, I felt like everything vibed really well together, and I was really feeling it. But again, formula-wise, it's just not an absolute favorite. Like, I wouldn't go out and repurchase from this particular Charlotte Tilbury lipstick formula. So that one is in Showgirl. Okay, so next up, I do have two different ones from Pat McGrath. Now, I've talked about the Pat McGrath Matte Trans lipsticks on my channel before. I'm just not a huge fan of the formula. I'm just simply not. I think I actually have one of the lipsticks in my makeup that I didn't get my money's worth out of, which went up earlier in the week, so I'll have it listed down below because I kind of give some more thoughts there. But I tried out two different little minis as well, and I have tried out the formula before. I purchased the full size in Christie. I actually had a friend buy the trio, and she sent me one of them to try out, and then I had someone actually send me the little trio as well. So I was trying more of the shades because you never know. So the ones that I tried out in December are in 1995 and then also Ami. I don't know if I'm saying that correctly, but this one here, it's always so funny to see the colors that I swatch. So this one here is in Ami. So that is that one. And then the other one that I tried out was in 1995. And I don't mind either of these colors. They look very, very similar to one another. So I don't mind either one of the colors. I think that they're just fine. I just don't love this formula. I feel, again, it's more of a matte bullet lipstick, but I still feel like it gets very, very crumbly on the lips, and especially when I wear it for a very long period of time, it really is like flaking off my lips. I do have dry lips. They're not as bad as they have been in the past, and I feel like recently they've been in pretty good shape, but I wore one of the lipsticks out the other night for like a friend's birthday party, and I was so embarrassed at how my lips were looking. I was continually trying to put gloss over the lipstick because it was just like flaking off my lips. I don't think it's like a super uncomfortable formula. Like sometimes the liquid lipsticks can get uncomfortably drying. I don't think it's necessarily like uncomfortable, but I don't think that it looks very attractive on my lips after several hours of wear, so it's not the best long wearing lipstick. So I tried out two more colors from Pat McGrath. Again, I like both these colors. I think I like 1995 just a little bit more. It's a little bit more on like the like nude pinky side, I think I would say. So I like that color just slightly more, but I won't mind it to wear for a little bit, you know, if I'm sitting down to film a video or if I'm just running somewhere, whatever. But if I'm going to have my lipstick on for a very long period of time, I won't go for this formula, and it's just not a favorite of mine. I know a lot of people really like it, but I also am not... Typically what I've found in the past, I'm not a huge fan of matte bullet lipsticks. Just something about them we are not compatible with. I typically go for a matte liquid lipstick instead. So again, all personal preference, of course. And then the last one that I have, so we have the Too Faced, we have the Showgirl, we have the two Pat McGrath, and then the last one is another one from Charlotte Tilbury. And again, this is kind of that, this isn't like a super bad product, but if I'm comparing everything that I tried, this one would have to be put into the bottom category. The other one that I thought about doing was the Profusion lip kit, because I did also wear that in the December videos, but I had actually put that in my November lip picks in the bottom five, so I didn't want to get super repetitive. So I thought I would put the Charlotte Tilbury in here. I don't mind it, but again, this is not going to be a personal favorite of mine. And this is the shade Happy Lips. So this is one of the, I didn't even say what it is. It's one of the Superstar, it doesn't say on here, Superstar Lips. I tried these out in my Charlotte Tilbury haul try-on video, and I did a couple different swatches in there. So again, I can have that one linked down below in case you want to see a few examples. So this one in Happy Lips, I don't love this color. I have another one in Sexy Lips, and even though this formula is not going to be my favorite, I like that color just a little bit more. This one is more coral, and it's a little bit more on the bright side, and it's just not something that I feel like I would wear a ton. So I just don't see myself getting a lot of use out of this. Again, this is more of that glossy formula. I like it because everything, like all the ones that I've tried, have been more pigmented. I'm not so much of a clear gloss girl. I like to have a little bit of oomph in there, and these definitely offer that while still giving you that glossy kind of like pouty look at the same time. Makes your lips, you know, appear a little bit bigger and all of that. So I don't mind that. It's not like, it's not the smoothest lip gloss I've ever tried. It's not like overly sticky or overly like my lips stick together type thing. But again, it's just not the absolute smoothest. I personally, again, like the Sexy Lips versus the Happy Lips. I don't see myself wearing this particular shade a ton. And again, formula-wise, it's just not going to be a favorite of mine. So if I'm having to choose, if I'm trying to be ruthless and choose my bottom five, this one would have to go into that category. So those are my bottom five for December. Why don't we go ahead and talk about some of my fave lip products. Alrighty, so like I was talking about with my preferences, matte liquid lips, you know, kind of like creamy bullet lipsticks, etc., I don't wear lip gloss a lot. I also don't wear lip liner a ton. I feel like I'm getting more into it these days, but sometimes a lip liner and a lip gloss combo will I will just appreciate so much. And that is what I have first to share here. And it's so funny, I remember as I was doing my makeup for this video, I was like, I'm doing lip liner and lip gloss, like, who am I? This is so not what I normally do, but I really, really love the combo, and I've worn it multiple times since then off camera. So that is the MAC Whirl lip liner, and then the Fussy what is this called? Fussy lip gloss bomb. I was gonna say lip balm, that did not sound right. The gloss bomb in Fussy. So this is the new shade. Okay, first of all, I mean, MAC Whirl, I've had this in my collection for a very long time. It's a very nice lip liner, don't get me wrong, but really the star of the show here is this Fenty gloss bomb. I wasn't sure I would totally love it, and I kind of doubted myself buying it because I'm like, you're not a lip gloss girl, what are you doing, why are you doing this? And I have the original one, and it's not an absolute fave of mine, but I don't like how kind of like orange it pulls on me. And with this one being pink, and I love pink makeup, I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna do it. And so far I don't regret it. I do really like this one. I've been wearing it quite a bit. I keep throwing it in my purse. I think that it's a really beautiful lip gloss, and I really do like this combo because even though Fussy has, you know, some pink in it, I still feel like it benefits from having more of a pink liner as well, and it just kind of really brings it out. And again, you can kind of overline your lips if you want to, or just kind of more define your lip shape, and then really fill it in with this pink gloss with that hint of sparkle in there. It makes your lips look nice and big. I think this is a very like flirty gloss, if you will. Like, I feel like I could go like flirt with the mailman when I wear this gloss. Where's the mailman? Where are you at? But yes, I feel a little bit flirty when I wear the Fussy gloss, and I've been really liking it. So this was definitely a combo that I appreciate it wearing in December. Okay, so the next one that I have, oh, the name of this one. This is from Too Faced. I've mentioned this in a Makeup Monthly in my favorite section. I like the formula, but I especially love this color so much. So again, this is from Too Faced. This is one of their, why does nothing tell me like what the formula is? It's one of their like peach lipsticks. It came in like their peach line, and this is called Sex on the Peach. Cause obviously, like, what do you do in your free time? This is what it looks like. So again, we have a bullet lipstick, and it does pull more matte, but again, I just find it to be really smooth and creamy on the lips. I love this kind of darker nude shade. I think that it's so beautiful. It does smell a lot of peaches. It has a very strong fragrance. Once I put it on my lips and let it sit for, you know, like 30 seconds, I don't smell it as much, but especially when I'm applying it, it's like peaches, 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 you know? But I love this color, and I remember I wore this once to a nail appointment, and the gal complimented me on my lip color, and I said thanks, and in my mind I was like, just please don't ask me the name, please don't ask me the name. And of course she's like, what's the name of it? So I had to say it, and the entire salon laughed at me, and I was like, thanks Too Faced, why you gotta do that to me? But I love this color. I really like this formula. This is one that I keep reaching for. I find this in my purse quite a bit because it's just such a beautiful color. So that one is from Too Faced. Next we have the wild card. There's usually, I feel like the lip liner and the lip gloss was a bit of a wild card, but this is even more of a wild card because it's a red lipstick. You do not see me in red lipsticks a lot. I have, you know, a few in my collection, but I just feel more confident in nude lips and mauve lips. I don't know what it is, because sometimes I can put on a really good red lip and I'm just like, yeah girl, get it. But then when I'm going to do my makeup, I just always go back to those nudes and the mauves. It's just who I am. But this one is from Persona Cosmetics. This is the Holy Grail Liquid Lipstick. This color is such a beautiful red. I just had a subscriber email me the other day and ask me for good like red lipstick recommendations. And this was one that I put in here because it's just a really beautiful, more of like that true red. I just think it's stunning. And I really do like the Persona Cosmetics liquid lipsticks. I did mention these in my Best of Beauty 2018 video. Like, look how beautiful that red is. It's more of a thinner formula, so it's more comfortable, which I appreciate. It's not the longest lasting liquid lipstick ever, but sometimes as you get more into like long wearing, you do get a little bit more on the drier side, where these are more comfortable. Like I said, they're thinner, so they're easy to reapply. If, you know, anything is worn away and you need to reapply, they're easy to do with this formula. And again, this red is just so beautiful. In last month's lip picks, I did mention OG, which is the nude, and that one is super stunning as well. But this one from Persona Cosmetics, I remember wearing it in a video and I had a red shirt on and I got so many compliments on it, which I always appreciate so much. Okay, and then the next one we have is one of my OG favorites. This is from Lawless Beauty, and this is in George. I'm so excited to be putting this into a lip picks because there is so many times with, especially with the shade George, it's just always in my purse. It's one of my go-to going out lipsticks because it's so long wearing, it's so comfortable. I love the color that it's always in my purse, and when I'm going to do my makeup, I just don't even, like, I don't see it in my collection because it's hidden away from me. And so I don't wear it as much in my videos. And I'm like, I really need to be wearing this because I want to be able to put it in my lip picks to tell people how much I enjoy it. I wore this one in my Best of Beauty 2018 video, which I thought was a great time to bust it out because I really fell in love with Lawless Beauty kind of as a whole in 2018, but especially their liquid lipsticks. This was their first launch as a brand, and I just think that they are beautiful. They are so expensive. They are $25, and I know that's pricey, and I have bought them myself, and I have waited for sales because that's a lot of money for one liquid lipstick. They smell nice. They have really nice packaging. This shade is George, which is just such a gorgeous kind of just true nude on me. Like I said, comfortable. They're a little bit more on the thicker side than like the Persona, but they're not too thick, they're not too moussey, they don't wear away super quickly, and they're just comfortable at the same time. It's just truly one of my favorite liquid lipstick formulas, and I just love George so much. So I'm so excited that they have finally made it into a lip picks. Alrighty, and then I just have one more left, and this is truly like an OG fave of mine. This is from MAC, and this is in Age, Sex, Location. Age, Sex, Location? Sex on the Beach? I have loved Age, Sex, Location since I got it, and I am so sad. This was actually a collaboration that Nicki Minaj did with MAC, and she put out like a huge collection of nude lipsticks, and this was in there, and unfortunately it is a limited edition shade, which has me so sad because I really, really like this. And let me see. Let me just go ahead and swatch it. Oh, I was kind of curious how similar it would be to Sex on the Peach, but it's really not. Sex on the Peach is more, that one is Sex on the Peach, more darker. And then, like, Age, Sex, Location is still a darker nude, but they're different. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. They're different. But I really do like this lipstick. I've talked about it a ton on my channel. I wear it a ton. It's in my purse a ton as well. I actually had it in my Project Pan for 2018. Then I lost it for a little bit. That was weird, but then I figured out that it was limited edition and I couldn't get it anymore, so then I kind of like scaled back. I was like, wait, maybe I don't want to use it all the way up, but I still love my Age, Sex, Location, wear it a ton, so definitely wanted to put that into my top five category as well. But these are my top picks. So again, I feel, you know, slightly different this month with the liner, with the gloss, with the red, and then nudes, you know. It just is what it is. But those are my top five lip picks for everything that I wore in my YouTube videos in the month of December. I hope that you guys enjoyed seeing another lip picks video. Let me know what you thought in the comments down below. As always though, if you guys did enjoy this video, I hope that you'll give it a thumbs up. I hope that you also consider subscribing before you go, and I'll catch you guys in tomorrow's video. Bye.